The Lord Drains with Nicky Ogamba.
Jesus Christ, you're watching The Lord Reigns at Open Door Communications Network, and we're so glad that you're watching the program tonight. We have something very, very special for you. We're doing a Christmas program, and our goal is to bring the joy of the Lord into your home wherever you might be.
Yes.
And I'm your host, Pastor Nick, and my co-host is my beautiful wife, Pastor Ruth. And tonight we're going to bring you songs, some wonderful Christmas carols. I'm going to bring a message a little bit later in the program, and it's going to be a wonderful time. I want you to invite your friends, call them on the phone,
yes.
Text them.
Oh, yes.
Have them watch this program because it's going to be wonderful. And for those of you that have a family and children, have them gather around the set because
yes.
I know they're going to enjoy it, and I know they're going to be blessed. And we here at OCN Broadcasting are happy to come to you tonight. This is the second Christmas season that we'll be celebrating with you, our viewers.
Yes.
And we love you. You're our
yes.
partners. And,
yes.
and we're so glad that that we can minister to you in song and in word and so many things that that we have to offer here at the network.
Yes.
And before we get started, honey, do you have something that's maybe on your heart that you can share just for a minute or two with
yeah.
our audience?
First of all, I want to say Merry Christmas, everyone. Christmas is such a wonderful, awesome time of year. And we want to remember tonight, we want to focus tonight on that babe in the manger. You know, I was watching a Christmas program on TV, and it was such a sweet program. They were all getting ready for the Christmas pageant. And they were getting the kings lined up, and different people were going to be the kings, and different people were going to be the shepherds, and then they had Mary, and they had the manger there, and then everybody gathered around. They said, we forgot to get the baby. So I just want to tell you, we want to focus on the baby. We want to focus on what God brought us to earth. And helped all of us, and redeemed all of us, and loves all of us. And so we're going to focus on the baby tonight. And so we want you to join us, and we're so pleased. We're going to, the very first song that we're going to sing together is Hark the Herald Angels Sing. And we believe the angels are rejoicing with us today. And the angels are pleased and happy. And they're singing in heaven with us today. So we want all of our angels out there that are watching to sing along with us.
And today we're celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, and it's being celebrated around the world. And in the message tonight, I'm going to share a little bit about the person of Jesus, because he's no longer a little infant in the manger.
Yes.
He's had a remarkable ministry, and he is alive today, and he sits at the right hand of the Father. And we hope by the end of the program that you'll get the true message of
yes.
Christmas, and you'll be able to celebrate
yes.
in Christmas. And there may be some of you out there that really are maybe a little lonely or a little sad, but we want to hopefully change that,
yes.
change your heart, change your attitude before the end of this program tonight.
Yes.
So
yes.
If you'd like,
okay. All right.
We have Pastor Ruth, who's really a gifted vocalist, and she's going to sing some Christmas carols for us tonight.
We're going to start out singing tonight. Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild. God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise. Join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem.
Continue singing tonight, Bethlehem Morning. Think about that child that came. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Cried for you.
to set us free. Up your heads. Jesus is coming to you today. Receive him.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Lord. We're going to continue our program tonight, and we are going to have a little play here, and I want you just to receive something of the Spirit of the Lord. Let's continue on with this medley. Worship along with us.
Thank you. so all the world would know the Savior sent from heaven, born that holy night. Jesus, our Emmanuel, came to give us life. The Savior sent from heaven, born that holy night.
Holy One of Israel, we worship you, we worship you, we worship you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Okay, baby, that's good. Thank you.
Thank you so much. The presence of God is so strong here at the studio, and I know that His anointing is going out wherever you may be watching. And I know that your life is going to be moved tonight, as our lives are moved. He's so precious, and this is a story that needs to be told. It's a never-ending story. We can tell it a thousand times, and it's still rich and current and up-to-date. And so tonight, I have the privilege of bringing the Christmas story to you and to your families. And it's a wonderful story. And if I could have slide number one, please. We're going to be looking at our foundational scripture tonight. And it really is the beginning of the story of Jesus. And it's found in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verse 7. And it says, "And she, Mary, brought forth her son, the firstborn, and wrapped him and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn." And we all know, or many of us have heard about the story of Jesus in the manger and in the stable and so forth. And we've even seen greeting cards that display the nativity scene. And many of us are familiar with the story of Jesus' birth. But tonight, I want to not only tell the story, because I know that there are many viewers who don't know about Jesus. Or maybe there's some children that you have that maybe never have heard the story of Christmas. So we want to tell that story that needs to be told. And I'm going to start tonight's message, and I'm going to be spending time, for those of you that may have a Bible, I'm going to be spending time in Luke chapter 2 and Matthew chapter 1 and the Gospel of John chapter 1. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell the story of Jesus, of course, his birth. We're going to talk a little bit about the wise men. And we're going to talk a little bit about the person of Jesus. And not just his birth, but the person of Jesus. And then we're going to conclude with the Christmas story about the shepherds, which is very, very powerful. And that needs to be told as well. And so I'm just going to start the message in Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 6, very familiar, a very popular text at this time of the year. And it starts off, it says that it happened in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus, and that all the world should be taxed. And remember, at this time, we have the Roman Empire, and the emperor of Rome, Caesar, was ruler over the entire world at that time, including the people of God, the Israelis, the people of God. And so he made a decree that they were to be taxed, but first they had to be registered. They had to go to their cities where originally from, where their tribes were from, and where the historical records were kept. And so we see here that all the people were told to register and to go to their own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee to be taxed, out of the city of Nazareth and into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David. And so Bethlehem, we're going to see, has a very important part of the story of Jesus. And we read further, and he took Mary, his betrothed wife, being with child. And while they were there, the days of her deliverance were fulfilled. In other words, she was due to have a baby, the Lord Jesus Christ. And so this is kind of the setting for our story, that they were brought from their home in Nazareth, quite a journey, maybe several days, maybe a week in those days, to come to Bethlehem. And they did do that. They obeyed the decree, and they came. And next, I want to talk to you about the wise men, because this is part of the story as well. And many of you are familiar with the Christmas story, you're familiar with the wise men. And I need to mention that in the story tonight, our Christmas story. And I'm going to go from the Gospel of Luke to the Gospel of Matthew. And we're going to be looking at chapter 2, verses 1 through 11. And that starts off by saying, "Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem." And these wise men were astronomers, and they knew about the things of God. They knew about the prophecies of God that they had heard from the prophets of old. And they would look at the heavens, and they would look for significant things that God might reveal to them by looking at the heavens. And they were told that one day there was going to be the Messiah was going to come into this world as a little baby and become a ruler. But they would know about it because there would be a large, huge star in the heavens that would give them the notice that this event was going to happen. And they've waited centuries and generation and generations. And so we see here that the wise men had seen this star. And so they knew that God was up to something. And they knew that if we follow the star, it's going to lead us to this Messiah, to the promised one, to the Savior, the Savior of the world. And so they came from the east, and they came to the king at that time, who was Herod. And they said, "We want to know where the king of the Jews is. Where is he? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." And I just want to tell you today that these wise men recognized that this wasn't just going to be a human coming into the human race, but it was going to be God coming into the human race. And so they knew that it was special. And so when they saw that star, they wanted to come into the presence of the newborn king and to worship him. And that really should be our response at this time of the year, to know Jesus in a personal way and to worship him and give glory to him that is due him. And in the message tonight, I'm going to give you an opportunity to know him in a personal way. And that's one of the reasons why we get so excited here at OCN, because we know the Savior, and we celebrate his birthday every year, the birth of him, but we just don't limit it to one day. We celebrate him every day. And that's what's special about a relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. So going on, the wise men are in the presence of King Herod, and they say, "We want to find this king of the Jews." And so we read on, and we see that Herod, the king, had heard these things, and he was troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. And the reason he was troubled, because he was the king in that region, and he didn't want anybody taking his place of power and prestige and so forth. And so that's why he was concerned. He was very insecure and didn't want anybody to interfere with his particular position that he had in the government there in that region. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them, "Where is this Christ? Where was he born?" And they said, "In Bethlehem of Judea." And when they, the wise men, had heard the king, they departed. They knew something was up. They knew that he didn't know, and that they sensed that Herod was upset and so forth. And so it says, the scripture says that they departed. And the star which they saw in the east went before them. So they saw the star again. And I was kind of meditating on this as I was preparing the message. And I was saying, well, if there was this great big star in the heavens, certainly other people noticed it. And they probably did, because it's historically been documented that there were these unusual celestial things at that time recorded in history. And so the people saw it, but they didn't know what it meant. And they didn't follow it. They didn't know to follow it, but the wise men did. And so we see here that they went and they stood over where the child was. So the star led them to where Jesus was, and they came to worship him. And they said, and the scripture says, and seeing the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And I hope that this Christmas season will bring you great joy. Amen. Because it's a time to celebrate. It's a time to celebrate Jesus. It's a time to celebrate with your family. It's a time to share gifts, but also to be thankful for what the Lord Jesus has done to the human race. He's probably the greatest person that ever lived in human history. And so it's important for us to have a relationship with him. And before the end of the program tonight, I'm going to give everyone an opportunity to have that relationship with Jesus if you do not have one at this time. And so coming into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshiped him. And that's what we do, us believers who know the Lord Jesus. We worship him. He's just not another famous person in history. He's much more than that. He's the Son of God. He's the promised Messiah. And I'll be touching a little bit more about that in the message. But the point is that they fell down before him and worshiped him. And opening their treasures, they presented him with gifts. Gifts that are worthy of a king. Here's the little infant. And they realized how important he was to the plan of God, to human history. And it says that they gave him gold. And you know, gold was valuable in those days, centuries ago, as it is today. It's a rare commodity that's very precious. And they came with gold, and they came with frankincense, and they came with myrrh, things that you would give royalty. And Jesus, the little infant, he certainly was royalty. And he had a wonderful destiny to fulfill, just like each one of us have a wonderful destiny. To fulfill. Yes. And so I just want to take a moment to pause in our story about the little baby Jesus and the story of Christmas. And I want to take some time to look at who this person Jesus really was. Because we know that he grew up in Nazareth and he had a ministry, a wonderful ministry, and he died, and he was crucified, and was raised from the dead. And we know that now he lives in heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. And so I want to mention this here, because this is important. He's not the little infant anymore. Yes, we do remember his birth, and he did change history. And he is an important person for us to study and to be related to. But I just want to take a moment for those of you who may not know about Jesus. Maybe you've never heard of Jesus before. And so first I want to look at his name, if I could have slide number 2, please. Who is Jesus? We see that the name Jesus is translated Savior. And in this passage that we're going to be studying in Matthew chapter 1, we're going to understand why the name Jesus was selected for the infant, the baby Jesus. And we see in Matthew chapter 1 that as he, Joseph, thought upon these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take you Mary as your wife, for that which is in her is fathered by the Holy Spirit. And so we have an example here of someone that was born into the human race that was born of God. And the reason that that happened was because of his destiny, the call on his life, the Lord Jesus. He was called to be the perfect sacrificial lamb, and he took our place on Calvary. So he had to be a man and God without sin. And so this was the only way that this could be accomplished, because if you look back in history and you find, you go back to the Genesis 1 where the Lord created the earth and the garden, and he created man and woman, you find out that that Adam sinned, and he fell short of the glory of God. And so that sin has been passed on from generation to generation to generation because of the human chain, so to speak, the human genealogies. But Jesus was born of God. He was born sinless.
Yes.
And he's the one who took our place on
yes.
Calvary
yes.
so that you and I could
yes.
have eternal life with the living God. And it's
Thank
just
you.
Precious.
Thank
and so to go on, the angel told Joseph in a dream, and she shall bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save the people from their sins. And so this was his life journey, his life assignment, was to save the people from their sins. And that's the meaning of his name, Jesus. That's the first part of how we refer to Jesus. We refer to him as Jesus Christ. That's the first part I want to talk about. And now all this happened, which was fulfilled and spoken by the Lord, by the prophet. So I also want to mention that Jesus' birth was so significant that God used the prophets of old, and I'm going to refer to Isaiah right now, and he made a prophecy through the prophet Isaiah 700 years before the Lord Jesus was born. And he said in Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14, "Behold, the virgin shall conceive in her womb and will bear a son, and they will call his name Emmanuel, which is interpreted God with us." So this was no ordinary baby. This was no ordinary person. It was God. It was God come into the flesh to dwell among us. And it was prophesied 700 years before his birth. So it was no accident. It was completely planned by God the Father in eternity past. And Joseph, being awakened from his sleep, did exactly as the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took his wife, and he called the baby his name, Jesus. Now, the second part that we refer to Jesus as Christ, that's a title, really, that is appropriate for the Lord Jesus, but that isn't his last name. Everybody says Jesus Christ and thinks that it's his last name, but really what it is, it describes the fact that he was the promised Messiah from years prior. And Christ comes from the Latin translation of the word Messiah. And the Jewish word Messiah means anointed one. And the anointed one was prophesied centuries earlier. And so all of the people of God who were Israel, people of Israel and Jewish people, they knew that one day Messiah would come. And they awaited that moment in history. But there were a lot of generations that came and went and didn't really get to see the fulfillment of this scripture, to see the anointed one, until Christ was born about 2,000 years ago in a little humble setting, in a stable where they kept the animals because there was no room for them at the inn. And we find out that there were so many people coming to Bethlehem to be registered that there were no vacancies, that the only place that was available was this humble beginning. Think of it, for a king, for our Lord Jesus Christ. He came in such a humble way, and we know that he's coming back as king one day soon, and we rejoice because of that.
Yes.
Now, if I could have slide number 3, please. We asked the question, was God just a good man? I mean, history has recorded that he was a good man, that he led a good life, and that he healed people and so forth. And many historians stop right there. And the question is asked, well, was he just a good man? And if we look at the scripture that you see on your screen, Acts chapter 10, verse 38, it says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. He was anointed. He was the living Son of God with the Holy Spirit and power. And he went about doing good and healing all those who were oppressed by the devil. For God was with him. So he was no ordinary man.
That's right.
Trust me. And this is recorded in the scriptures here, so we know that it's true. We know it's the word of God. Okay, another question comes up. If I could have slide number 4. Was he a prophet? Because the Messiah was prophesied many centuries earlier, and prophets were the one who not only understood God, but spoke the word of God to the people. And Jesus certainly did this. We know the Sermon on the Mount. We know that there's so many other examples of Jesus bringing God's word to the people. And he still does today, because we have the Holy Scriptures. Yes. We have the word of God today.
Yes.
And so on this screen here that you see, many centuries earlier, I have a quote here from Moses, who is considered one of the greatest prophets of all times of the Hebrew nation and the community of God. And this is what he had to say about our Lord Jesus. He said, Jehovah your God will raise up to you a prophet, with a capital P, which refers to deity, which refers to God, from the midst of you and your brothers, one like me. To him you shall listen. So Moses spoke of our Lord Jesus Christ, yes. Excuse me, centuries before he came into the human race here with us. And so the answer to the two questions that I raised was he just a good person? Was he a prophet? I think the answer is no. He was Jesus. He was the living Son of God. He was no human person.
That's right.
He came into our world, into the human race to redeem us, to save us from our sins.
Yes.
And I also want to mention right now, I'll just share it with you. It comes from one of the prophets in the Old Testament. And the prophet's name is Micah. And many times this scripture is mentioned as part of the Christmas story. And I want to read it to you. And it says, and you, Bethlehem, you being the least among the thousands of Judah, out of you he shall come forth to me to become ruler in Israel. He whose goings forth have been from old, from the days of eternity. That was spoken by the prophet Micah. Chapter 5, verse 2. And it was speaking of Messiah that would come one day. And so if I could have slide number 5, please. I want to share with you that Jesus came from eternity past to redeem us. And he became flesh. He became man, but he was also God at the same time. And the scripture that you see on your screen is taken from the Gospel of John, and I just want to read it to you because it's so profound, and I think it's definitely a part of the Christmas story that we're sharing with you tonight. Verse number 1 in John chapter 1 says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and he, Jesus, was in the beginning with God. And all things came into being through him, and without him, not even one thing came into being. And so we see that Jesus is eternal. He resides with the Godhead, with God the Father, himself, and the Holy Spirit. And they had a plan of redemption from the foundations of the earth. And we see here And also in verse 14, it says that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. So we see that Jesus volunteered to come into the human race to redeem and to save the human race, to save you and I, so that we could have a relationship for all eternity with the living God. And it's a choice that God gives each one of us. And in a moment, I'm going to give you an opportunity to do that, because I know that many of you who are watching, this Jesus is inviting you to a relationship with Him. And it's not just for Christmas. It's for eternity. It's for your life. It's for the length of your life and eternity, plus eternity. And so the last thing that I want to do is to talk to you about the shepherds. Come back to the Christmas story again. And in the Christmas story, the shepherds, we see this is a situation and a setting that occurred before the birth of Jesus. And in Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 20, it says that in the same country there were shepherds living in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord came to them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them, and they were grievously afraid. They had never seen angels. They had never seen them in all of their glory. And they were out in the fields tending their herds. And they were afraid. It was something very different than what they were used to. And it was very special because God had decided that He was going to announce the birth of Jesus to these shepherds through an angel. And it says that the angel of the Lord came on them, and the glory of the Lord showed, and they were afraid. And the angel said to them, "Do not fear, for behold, I give you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For to you is born today in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this is a sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with an angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." And you know, today we're still believing God for peace in the world. Yes. Not only peace among fellow men, but peace, yes, with God. There's been a, yes, separation, and people have been, that's separated, right, from God. And you know that God loves everything that He's created. He loves you. He loves me. And He wants to have a relationship with you. And so we read a little bit further that it happened that the angels departed from them into heaven, and the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has happened." And there are many who are seeking Jesus. They want to see Him. They want to have a relationship with Him.
Yes.
And you can have a relationship with Him.
Yes.
And just to wrap up the story about the shepherds, we read that the shepherds returned after they had found Jesus and Mary and Joseph. It says the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen. And so that's our response,
yes,
at this time of the year and every,
yes,
Christmas.
Yes.
And do you know that wise men still seek God? That's something that just didn't happen 2,000 years ago, but it's happened all during the 2,000 years and right now in our generation at this,
yes,
present time in history.
Yes.
And so I just want to wrap up the program tonight. If I could have slide number 6. There's a scripture verse that I believe that was chosen by God just for you tonight. It says, "But as many as that have received Him, He gave to them authority to become children of God, to those who believe in His name, And as all you have to do tonight is to believe on his name.
Yes.
And I'm going to lead you in a prayer tonight. And I want you to put aside any distractions. And if there's children watching, I ask you to be still and be quiet. And just look into the screen and say this prayer after me. For those of you who have never known about Jesus or have never invited him into your heart, I'm going to give you an opportunity in just a minute. But there may be many of you out there who gave your heart to the Lord years ago, but you've wandered far away from him. And he wants to have a relationship with you. He wants to renew that relationship with you. So I'm speaking to you as well as the people who want to know Jesus. And I'm going to lead you in a prayer right now. And I want you to look into the screen and I want you to say these words after me. Say, Lord Jesus. I am a sinner. I have blown it so many times. But I ask you to forgive me of my sins. I believe that you took my place on Calvary and you paid the penalty by your shed blood for all of my transgressions. And that when I open up my heart to you, that you will come into my heart and you have forgiven all of my sins. And I promise to follow you all the days of my life. Amen. Now, if you said that prayer with me, Pastor Nick, I celebrate with you because you've been born again. You have an eternal relationship with the Lord Jesus for all eternity. And we celebrate that. And all of heaven is rejoicing tonight. And we want to hear from you. Please give us a call or connect with us on OCN Broadcasting .com. There's a connect button. You can connect with us and tell us of your decision to invite the Lord Jesus into your life. And we want to pray for you and we want to help you on your journey with the Lord Jesus Christ, not only through our programming, but a little bit more personal than that. And also you can write to us. You can write to us at OCN Broadcasting, P.O. Box 45465. There it is on your screen, Los Angeles, California, 90045. Or you can call us at area code 323-596-4755. And so I see that we're just about out of time, and I want to thank you for watching OCN Broadcasting, for watching this program. And we here at OCN believe that the Word of God can change your life, and it will change your life. Just cry out to Him, pray to Him, and He has promised to answer you and to be your Lord and your Savior. And so until the next time we see you here at OCN Broadcasting, may God richly bless you. We love you so much. And just enjoy this Christmas season. It's so special. And He has come to give you joy, to give you happiness. And we just say goodbye to you, and God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.